Hey guys, my name's Keith. I'm the senior designer here at Dolo Digital. And today I'm going to give you a little tutorial about how to add depth and texture to your vector illustrations using patterns in the shading. So I've set up a little example here using a moon shape. We do a lot of space graphics here at Dolo, sort of our brand theme. So I figured that would be a good way to show this technique. And you can see here just a basic shape, two shades of purple, a light and a dark, and the light is hitting the object from the right hand side, so the shading is off to the left, and it's just solid right now. So you can see it's distinguishable as a moon, but we're going to add a little bit more of a dynamic feel to it with these patterns. So you can see here that instead of a solid fill, I've just sort of used a pattern colored in the same dark purple to fill in that shaded area. All I did was take a basic line pattern that was black, go to Object, Pattern, Edit Pattern, and that will give you the breakdown of everything that makes up the pattern. So I just changed the color to that dark purple, saved it as a new swatch, and that is how I got that. You can see it's already kind of transforming how the illustration looks. In this next step, I just added circles behind all of those small craters and did the same thing. Sort of added that dark line pattern to match what was going on the left-hand side. So you could stop here if you'd like, but if you wanted to add a little bit more contrast, you can sort of combine those techniques. So you leave the dark shaded purple areas, but over the top of those, you create extra layers and use a light purple line pattern instead of a dark purple. You edit it the same way where you just go ahead and edit your pattern and use a light purple instead of the dark purple. You can see how that adds a little bit more depth and contrast to it. And in the final step, I selected those light purple shaded areas and just rotated the pattern a little bit to have it on more of a diagonal. I think it just adds a little bit more visual interest to it. And to do that, you would just go to Object, Transform, Rotate, and make sure that you have transform objects unclicked, and then you can use the angle here to change those line patterns to whatever you'd like. So I hope that's been a little bit informative for you. Feel free to experiment with it, and I'm sure there are many, many ways. Like, this is just a line pattern, but there's a lot of different patterns and shapes that you could use with this shading technique. Thanks.